In this HostGator review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about HostGator before deciding if they are the right hosting provider for you. I will provide you with the most comprehensive review where I will break down the pricing structure and show you how to get the best deal currently available with HostGator. I will guide you through their entire sign-up process and judge how easy their platform is to use. I will then grade their performance based on page load speed and uptime from the HostGator plan that I purchased. Lastly, I will provide you with the pros and cons and my honest recommendation if or who should buy HostGator. At the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up HostGator through my link below. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free and a way of saying thank you. In this course, I show you how to set up your WordPress website the right way, how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance, and how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now let's get straight into this review. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It'll take you to my special HostGator discount page where you will get the best discount HostGator is currently offering. And if you put in the promo code .comdollar at the checkout page, you will get an extra discount too. I will be comparing their shared hosting plans, although HostGator does offer other types of hosting, like dedicated hosting or VPS hosting, so they can support you when your business grows and you are ready for an upgrade. There are three shared hosting plans. With the Hatchling tier, you are limited to just one website. However, the next two plans allow you to have unlimited websites. The business plan, which is their most expensive plan, comes with a dedicated IP address, which the mid-tier baby plan does not have. This feature I don't think is worth the extra money for shared hosting, but if you really need it, you know it's there. A great feature I really like, which HostGator provides, and not many other hosting provider does, is their free website transfer. This is really handy for someone moving their website over from another hosting provider, as HostGator's support team will do this for you for free. There's two main features that I believe are very standard for hosting provider, which HostGator is missing. The first is their automatic backup. They don't provide this in any of their plans, as I think it's a must-have feature. And the second thing is the lack of speed optimization on their higher plans. Usually all higher plans normally come with the better speed optimization or custom cache plugins to boost up the speed. But HostGator does not provide this at all, so I really see no value in choosing their most expensive plans here. That being said, in terms of pricing, I would only ever consider their Hatchling plan if you only need one website. But if you require multiple websites, then the baby plan should be more than enough for you. Don't waste money on their business plan. So now I will choose their Hatchling plan for this tutorial to test them out. Now let's talk about domain names. I really have a problem with domain names that these hosting providers charge you. Other YouTubers won't tell you this, and it really annoys me, so I'm gonna be honest and break this all down for you right now. First, I really don't suggest you buy any of your domain names from any hosting providers, as they usually charge you much higher than a dedicated domain name provider. Right now, for HostGator, even though the domain name is included for you for free for the first year, you still have to pay $14.95 for the domain privacy, which is a must-have for me, as I don't want marketers emailing and calling me every day to offer their services. And then every year after that, you have to pay $17.95 for domain name renewal and $14.95 again for the domain name privacy renewal. This total is around $33 every year, which is ridiculous to me. What I recommend you do instead is buy all your domain names from Namecheap.com. I use them for all my domain names, and you can get your domain name for under $9 for your first year, with the domain privacy included for free. And it will only cost you $12.98 to renew each year, which is almost three times cheaper than HostGator. So that is a no-brainer for me, and I recommend you do the same. If you need help with getting your domain from Namecheap, then you can check out this video here where I guide you through step-by-step how to do it. HostGator comes with six different payment plans but you can clearly see it's not worth doing anything under 12 months, as the monthly cost just doesn't make sense. Obviously, the longer the deal, the cheaper it gets. Generally, I would always suggest you to buy the 36-month plan, as you get the cheapest price and you will have no reason to leave once you have picked a great hosting provider that you're happy with. Not saying HostGator is that yet. They still have a lot of testing requirements to pass. But if you're not happy with HostGator, at least they have a 45-day money-back guarantee, so you can get a full refund from them. I also want to let you know that if you get this free domain name provided by them, they will still charge you for that part, as the domain name cannot be refunded. So just be careful on that. The next part is the additional add-on services. They pre-selected the SSL certificate and the site backup for you. These two features you can get for free, and most hosting providers should provide you this for free anyway. So I'm gonna deselect both of them as you don't need it. Quick note here, if you type in my coupon code .comdollar into this field and click validate, you will get an extra discount on your plan with HostGator. So that is a good little bonus to have. Once you're happy with your plan, just accept the terms of service and click checkout now. The overall pricing score I would give HostGator is a 7 out of 10. I took a few marks off as they don't offer a lot of features and their more expensive plans don't provide enough value to be worth the money. Automatic backup is also not included in any of their plans, which I think is really important to have. On the other hand, the price of their lower tier options are very cheap and comparable to other cheaper hosting providers. Plus, they provide you with free site migration, which is a really handy feature to have. So I would say they are a cost-effective hosting provider overall. But the big question is, how well do they perform on my speed test? Keep watching to find out. After purchase, setup, and ease of use. You're probably wondering what HostGator's backend actually look like and would like to know how easy it is to install and manage your WordPress website, right? I will now show you just that. Right away from their homepage, you can see it looks very easy to navigate with the custom interface compared to the cPanel that a lot of other hosting providers use. But if you ever wanted to manage your site with cPanel, you can just click this button and it will take you to your normal cPanel setup which you are used to. It's that easy. Now let's see how easy it is to install and create our own WordPress website. So from your dashboard, you'd click on Manage Package and it will take you to the domain name that you registered with HostGator. One thing that's not good with HostGator is they present you with too many upgrade options. Look at all these options here. These are all learn more and you go to upgrade, right? So I don't like that at all. The main real estate on your dashboard or your hosting dashboard should be of all the tools that you can actually use to build your website properly. You go down further to the bottom here and go to the one-click install. And it will take you to this page here. You click on WordPress, select your domain, click on next, fill out your information here, agree to the terms of service, and then click install. Now there is one extra step that you will have to do compared to installing it from a cPanel, which is go to your email address and they will send you your password. So I'm just gonna click on the admin URL, put my information in, click on login, and now I'm in the back end. So overall, it's not as easy as other hosting providers' one-click installation because you have to go and check your email for the password, but overall, it's easy enough. And now what about creating an email account? Let's see how easy that is. So you think when you want to create an email address, you would click on the email and offers section, right? Well, that's wrong, because if you click on there, they're gonna take you to the paid options again. They're going to try to upsell you to either a Microsoft or a G Suite account, which you have to pay monthly. So to install it for free, you need to go to Hosting, click on cPanel, then select Email Accounts, and enter in your email address. And click on Create Account. And you see the account has been created. So it's that simple. Once again, this was easy to create, but they are not quite upfront with trying to upsell you to make you pay for an email address. Overall, I would score HostGator an 8 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really like that it's simple to install your WordPress site, and having the option to access the cPanel is also very handy for experienced WordPress users. I did take 2 marks away from them because they don't guide you well when setting up a new domain name from another provider, and they mislead you on things like setting up your free email address. They tend to hide the free stuff and pack the interface with too many upgrades and ads because I think it is a really well designed backend. Speed and uptime performance tests. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. The result is 1.7 seconds. This is not looking promising, but I won't judge them now as I have not optimized their website yet. Now I will take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry, if you're overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I am also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. The first is WP Fastest Cache. This is for the speed optimization. And the next one is the Short Pixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare app, which will also increase your website performance with their CDN. Now overall, this will make it a fairer test because it will make it more comparable to what you would do in real life. One quick note I need to mention to you is, if you install WordPress with HostGator, you can't install anything above 5.0 because HostGator does not run the latest PHP version, which for me is not good enough. The speed is now 3.9 seconds, which is too slow for me. HostGator has turned out to be one of the slowest hosting providers I have tested out so far. Google also recommends a site to load in under 3 seconds, so HostGator also missed this mark by a fair way. I have also been monitoring the stability performance of HostGator with Uptime Robot, and I can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is only 99.895%. This is way below my standard of 99.95% uptime and even HostGator's own uptime guarantee of 99.9%. I was very disappointed with this result and HostGator has really dropped the ball on this one. Overall, I would rate HostGator's speed and uptime performance only a 4 out of 10. I took 4 marks away for massively failing the speed test and 2 marks for failing their own uptime guarantee. It is a pretty simple fail here, and there's not much else to say about it. Here's a quick question for you. What is your current page load speed, and who is your hosting provider? Let me know in the comments section below. Support. HostGator provides 24/7 customer support through email, live chat, and phone support. I will test them out by asking them these 3 different questions on the live chat. 1. I will tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. 2. I will ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs, but I made sure to choose the wrong question category. 3. I ask them if they could do me a favor and install an SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. And here are the results. For the first question, they told me that it would cost extra and I needed to buy the add-on package for them to remove it. They were willing to help locate the malware when I asked for that specifically, which was helpful. However, their downfall was that it took almost 30 minutes of waiting time, and at the end of the conversation, the support staff told me that he is forwarded to a specialist and he will scan and send the report separately later. I expected that after waiting for 30 minutes, I would get the report already. So I was really disappointed with HostGator's support team for that. For the second question, they were able to provide me with the right answers here, but they were not straightforward and had to clarify a few times. And overall, it took almost 20 minutes to sort the whole thing out from start to finish. So I think it was a bit too long there too. And for the third question, they were willing to help here with no hesitation, but seemed they misunderstood a few things. They repeated some information twice, even though I had already answered the question, And lastly, they tried to just give me links to steps for installing Cloudflare instead of trying to guide me step by step like I originally asked. And by the way, the instructions were not a custom one made by HostGator. It was just a website link from Cloudflare itself. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at 3 different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So the 3 times were 11.5 minutes, and the next 2 were both 50 seconds. The average of those 3 times turns out to be around 4.5 minute wait, which is definitely more than acceptable. I think anything under 5 minutes is great, so good work to HostGator on that part. Overall, I would have to score HostGator's support a 6 out of 10. I would say their support was average. It was nothing great, but it wasn't the worst either. They had a decent response time, but the quality of the support was lacking in terms of support team's level of knowledge and know-how. So what do you think of all the stats and figures from my testing so far? Do you like the level of detail? If so, make sure to like my video and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on future content I release every single week, just like this. Features, cons. So let me first start off with the cons. The biggest issue I have with HostGator is their website speed. It is very slow compared to other hosting providers in the same budget category. At 3.9 seconds load time, it's just too slow, and I would never use this for my own websites. The next con was their uptime. This was also very poor, as I always expected a hosting provider to have a minimum of 99.95% uptime to be worth considering. HostGator missed this by a long shot and even failed their own 99.9% guarantee. They only managed to achieve 99.895% uptime, which is nowhere near good enough. The next con is they only have 2 server locations, which are both located in the United States. So for anyone with their main source of traffic coming from anywhere else in the world, the website speed will be much too slow and HostGator would probably not be suited to you. Automatic backup is a very important feature, and this is something that HostGator also lacks, which is not good enough nowadays. Every decent hosting provider is expected to have this, plain and simple. You really can't underestimate how critical this feature is for your website. Next thing is their support staff technical knowledge. This was lacking, and they were not able to provide a level of service compared to other hosting providers I tested. The last one isn't a big deal for some, but they just annoyed me a bit with always trying to upsell and making it hard to find free options, like for installing the WordPress site and setting up an email address, which I showed you previously. Features, pro. The first pro is that HostGator offer free website migration. This means that HostGator will move your website from your existing provider to them for free when you sign up with them. You simply just have to open a ticket, fill out the form, and their technical support team will take care of it for you. Not many shared hosting providers offer this to you for free, so kudos to HostGator. The second biggest pro is their intuitive backend system, which I believe is much easier to navigate and use than cPanel. But they also have that option for you if you require. This may not be a big deal for someone who has been building websites for a while, but it is a big plus for beginners just starting out. Overall, I have given HostGator an average score of 6 out of 10. Apart from the pricing, the free website migration, and the nice user interface, HostGator under-deliver on a lot of things for me. I believe they used to be great a few years back, but they are not there anymore. Maybe it's something to do with being owned by EIG, but I will leave that topic alone in this unbiased review. They are not a reliable hosting provider, as they perform really poorly in the uptime tests, and their speed does not reach Google's recommendations. So I really cannot recommend this hosting provider to you. I believe there are much better options out there for a similar price range on the market.
This is a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up HostGator through my link, then simply just send me your full receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you back the access to my bonus course right away. It's that simple. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step of starting your business. So if after watching this review, you agree with me that HostGator is probably not the right option for you, then come along with me to this video where I show you my number one hosting alternative that I have personally tested and used myself. So I'll see you in that next video.